Hey guys, Gilles here for Premiere Basics, a weekly series where I'll tell you the ins and outs of Adobe Premiere Pro. Can you make animations in Premiere? Sure you can, with keyframes. But what are keyframes exactly, and how do we use them in Premiere Pro? Well, we already talked a bit about keyframes in the pen tool video, the speed ramping video, and the masking tutorial, but this time I will get more in depth. Let's start off with the most important question: what is a keyframe? A keyframe is a specific point in time where you can assign a property value to, like for instance positioning or scaling. We use these keyframes to create animations in video or audio clips. So let's jump straight into Premiere Pro and start animating a clip. To start off, select a clip and head over to the Effects Controls panel. We'll start with making a simple zoom animation. First, we'll place a keyframe in the beginning of our clip, and you can do this by clicking on the stopwatch icon next to the property. You will now see a diamond-shaped point in the clip timeline. This diamond point is a keyframe. If we look at our property, this keyframe now has a value of 100% scaling. So let's go a bit further in time and assign a new keyframe. We can do this by clicking on this point right here. On this keyframe, we will assign a value of 150% scaling. If we now play the clip, we will already see a zoom animation. If we want this zoom animation to go slower, then we can drag the last keyframe further in time. If we want to make it faster, then we'll place it closer to the first keyframe. So the positioning of a keyframe to another keyframe affects the speed of your animation. You can of course apply these keyframes to most properties in the Effects Controls panel and to loads of other effects. But let's dive a bit deeper in the animation that we've made already. When playing the clip, you will see that the animation is a bit harsh, so we want to smoothen this. We've already seen something similar in a speed ramping video. What we basically want to do is ramp these keyframes so that they start and end smoothly. This is called easing the keyframes. You can do this by right-clicking on the first keyframe and selecting Ease Out. Now, oftentimes people ask me, Jill, when do we use Ease Out and when do we use Ease In? Well, it's actually really simple. An animation always has a beginning keyframe, which lets the animation start. So it goes out of that point. Now, you don't want it to be harsh, you want it to be smooth. So ease the animation that goes out. An animation also has an end keyframe, where it comes back in. So we want it to ease in. To make you understand it even more, we're going to visualize this animation with a curve. If it's a pike with straight lines, it is harsh. We call this a linear curve. When it's a wave, it's smooth. And a smooth wave is what we call a bezier. You can visualize this in Premiere Pro by clicking on a small arrow on the left of the property. This will create a drop-down where you will see a curve in your clip timeline now. If you want to alter the smoothness of your animation even more, you can use the handles of the bezier. Another way we can use keyframes is in the timeline itself. If we right-click on a clip, we can show the keyframes for either motion, opacity, or time remapping. We've already been over the time remapping in our speed ramping tutorial. We can place keyframes here with either the pen tool or just using P on your keyboard. The motion keyframes and the opacity keyframes are the exact same as the ones in the Effects Controls panel, but some people prefer to do it this way. I personally never use the keyframes for motion and opacity in the timeline because I always use the effect controls. However, if you have a big timeline and you want to have a nice overview of the animations on different clips and different layers, then you can do this in the timeline, of course. Another place where we can create keyframes is in the audio. We can use this to change the volume of a clip on a specific part. For instance, when someone is talking and you don't want background music to attract a lot of attention. Or for instance, when someone is shouting really loud and then he's talking really, really, really silent. Now, with the use of keyframes, I can increase the part that is too silent and decrease the part that is too loud. So everything matches perfectly. And that's basically it, guys. Now, don't forget that you can have as much keyframes as you want in a clip, and of course on multiple effects at once. If it's a bit hard to understand, just play around with it, and in no time you will get the flow. And if you like keyframes and want to learn even more, like masking for instance, I highly recommend watching our masking class on Skillshare. When you click on the first link down below, you will get 2 months completely for free with access to our classes and thousands of others. So definitely check it out. I'll see you guys next week, and as always, stay creative.